Would Netaji have approved of a Haridwar Dharam Sansad that issues blood-curdling calls for Muslim genocide? The INA's mottos were three Urdu words: Ittehad, Itmad, and Qurbani. You want to get inside our heads, inside our homes, to tell us what to eat, what to wear, who to love, where a Jain boy can hide from home and enjoy a kati kebab on a street car in Ahmedabad. So what do? You forbid non-vegetarian street food in Gujarat municipalities. जिस सुबह की खातिर जुग जुग से हम सब मर मर के जीते हैं, वो सुबह कभी तो आएगी। इन भूखी प्यासी रूहों पर एक दिन तो करम फरमाएगी, वो सुबह कभी तो आएगी। Honorable Speaker, sir, my esteemed colleagues, I stand today to respond to the Honorable President's address on behalf of my party, the All India Trinamool Congress. The President's address is the government's assessment of the State of the Union today. And I stand before you to vehemently disagree with that assessment and to ask the most important question that faces us all. What is the kind of republic we want? What is the India that we want today? What is our idea of India that we are willing to stand up for, fight for, be abused for, get jailed for? Ours is a living constitution. It breathes as long as we are willing to breathe life into it. Otherwise, it's just a piece of paper, black and white, that can be smudged into shades of grey by any majoritarian government. An elected government bears the people's trust to uphold the constitution, both in letter as well as in spirit. If the government fails, we all fail. So it is not enough for Indians to sit back and watch and wish each other a happy Republic Day. This government wants to alter history. They are fearful of the future and they mistrust the present. Robert F. Kennedy in the 1960s had warned of such hateful forces. The Honorable President, early on in his address, speaks about freedom fighters who secured India's rights. He speaks of Guru Tegh Bahadur, V.O. Chidambaram Pillai, and Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose. But this is just lip service. In reality, recalling India's past, a past of decency, a past of plurality, a past of secularism, makes this government very, very insecure. This government has reinvented Savarkar as a freedom fighter. The apology letter he wrote to the British begging for release is now being recast as some kind of strategic masterstroke. The appropriation of Bhagat Singh, who was staunchly anti-fascist, the appropriation of Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel, who banned the RSS after becoming Home Minister. The President's address refers to Netaji on multiple occasions. I will remind this Republic that this is the same Netaji who said, the government of India should have an absolutely neutral and impartial attitude towards all religions. Would Netaji have approved of a Haridwar Dharam Sansad that issues blood-curdling calls for Muslim genocide? On June 14, 1938, in Kumilla, now Bangladesh, Netaji said, communalism has raised its ugly head in an all-out nakedness. Netaji's Indian National Army's insignia was Tipu Sultan's springing tiger, the same Tipu Sultan that you erased from our textbooks, after whom you cannot bear to name roads or sports stadiums. The INA's mottos were three Urdu words: Ittehad, Itmad, and Qurbani. Unity, trust, and sacrifice. The same Urdu language that this government is so delighted to replace with Hindi as the first and official language of Jammu and Kashmir. The President's address refers to Khadi being a symbol of consciousness under the leadership of Bapu. But the unholy Dharam Sansad issue calls to kill Bapu all over again. You have already succeeded in glorifying Gandhi's assassins, but just for the sake of those children who will grow up watching Beating the Retreat without his favorite hymn. The President's speech lauds these great personalities for fighting for our rights, but in reality, the masters of our republic fear their own irrelevance if in future India and Indians are actually guaranteed the rights and liberties enshrined in our constitution. The Freedom House Report 2021 changes India's status from free to partly free. The World Press Freedom Index, India retains 142nd spot out of 180, remains one of the most dangerous places globally for journalists today. आप कह रहे हैं प्रेम से बोलने पर रामधारी सिंह दिनकर का एक कविता हम आपको बोल दे सहनशीलता क्षमता सहनशीलता क्षमा दया को तब पूछता जग है, बल का दर्प चमकता उसके पीछे जब जगमग है। तो सहनशीलता क्षमा सब देंगे पर पीछे थोड़ा तो बल का दर्प होना भी चाहिए। सो यू फियर इन इंडिया वेयर अ जैन बॉय कैन हाइड फ्रॉम होम एंड एंजॉय अ काठी कबाब ऑन अ स्ट्रीट कार इन अहमदाबाद। सो व्हाट डू? यू फॉरबिड नॉन वेजिटेरियन स्ट्रीट फूड इन गुजरात म्युनिसिपैलिटीज। यू फियर द फ्यूचर वेयर ऑन द ईव ऑफ एन इलेक्शन यू मे नॉट बी एबल टू आर्म ट्विस्ट गवर्नमेंट एजेंसीज टू रेड अपोजिशन लीडर्स। So you need to extend the tenure of the CBI and ED chiefs depending on how they do your bidding. You fear a future in which bureaucrats in a state cannot be bullied by the center. So you amend the IAS cadre rules. This fear of irrelevance in the future makes you behave the way you do. You are not content with just our vote. You want to get inside our heads, inside our homes, to tell us what to eat, what to wear, who to love. But your fear alone cannot keep the future at bay.